Hi, I'm your host today, Arlene Tognetti, and our guest panel of wonderful healers and readers that I want to introduce to you. We know that there are tough times ahead in this 21st century, and all our guests today will be talking about their specialties and expertise in the field of their work. We're looking forward to 2012 because we know it's going to be a great time and also a stressful time. So here we are today. My first guest is going to be Robert Boyer. He's an author and good friend. Robert Boyer, how are you today?
Wonderful. Good. How are you?
Great. Great. I'm so proud to introduce your first book. It's Gilman's Parallel, The French King. And I wanted our viewers to get a little background on this. Like, what was the inspiration to start this book metaphysically? I know it's a metaphysical journey, but I want the audience to know, how did you start and what was your inspiration for the character?
Well, true story, my wife bought me a computer in 2001. And I spent the entire day setting it up. And about 11 o'clock at night, I finally got it working. The only thing I knew how to do was write emails. So I wrote the first three chapters and sent them to myself as emails. Mm-hmm. And I loosely based the main character, whose name is Robin Gilman, mm-hmm, yes, upon some of my own life experiences. It's a bit of a catharsis.
That's great. That's great. So the first time you ever touched the computer was to write the first, what, three chapters?
That night.
Oh, man.
I was up late.
And tell us a little bit about the journey itself. What are the experiences this character goes through? And how would our audience enjoy... We know there's parallel lives. We believe in that. We all metaphysically know that there's other dimensions. And give us a hint on how this fellow goes through his journey in life.
Okay. Now, Gilman's Parallel, The French King, is the first book of a metaphysical trilogy fantasy.
Okay.
And Robin Gilman discovers he has an evil destiny, but he rejects his own evil destiny. That's a momentous decision for him.
Yes.
But he also discovers that there's a parallel universe. And in this parallel universe, he has a parallel life. And his parallel life wants to be this evil destiny.
Mm. Wow. That's fascinating. And he chooses this.
He chooses to choose it. Yeah.
Wow. And the experiences follow that after that.
The experiences follow that because he interacts with the parallel universe. He interacts with all the magical creatures that live in the other universe, mm-hmm, because we don't believe in them, mm-hmm, in this one.
Right.
That's why we don't see fairies or gnomes or, mm-hmm, leprechauns. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. They live in the other universe.
Mm-hmm. Different dimensions. Right.
Different dimensions.
You have now the trilogy. You have two more books then that are going to be, you're writing the second, and there'll be a third,
yes,
coming out.
The second is titled Gilman's Parallel, The Doppelganger, mm-hmm, and it's not published yet. I hope to have it published sometime next year.
Mm-hmm. Great.
And I haven't titled the third book yet, but as soon as I can go through the process of publishing number two, mm-hmm, I might actually start work on number three.
That's great. And yeah, what you were thinking about, even a screenplay or possibly doing a theater, even a children's theater, kind of like a play where you can get the imagination out of this, can also bring into, you know, children and adults could even work with a screenplay, or it'd be interesting to work with this metaphysically for young people.
Well, you know, and imagination has a lot to do with it.
That's right.
It's a very,
that's right,
powerful tool.
Yes, it is.
We can manifest things by using our imagination. Mm-hmm. This is something Robin does in the book.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And I've had people who have read the book tell me this should be shopped around. Mm-hmm. In the movie industry, this needs to get made into a movie. Mm-hmm. That would be nice. I would like that.
One of these days, right?
Yeah. One of these days soon.
That's right. And you started this whole process in 2001, the writer in you came out in 2001.
Yeah.
That's great. We're in 2011 right now, just ready for 2012.
2012
is
the beginning.
The book is the beginning. Yeah. So thank you, Robert. This is great.
Thank you.
We're going to see you get the second one out. And thank you for being our guest today. It's wonderful.
Oh, you're welcome. And this book is available at Amazon.com. Mm-hmm. It's also a Kindle. Mm-hmm. And if you can find me when I'm selling it, I will actually autograph the book.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
And sell it to you myself.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me here.
You're welcome. And now we're looking at our three guest panelists we have today. Les Bell, Reverend Raea Sunshine, and Ron Kalvin. Beautiful. What they have to offer today for us, we're going to talk about healing, the healing process of energy, how each of them have worked with different clients, different people, different situations, and their stories to tell us about what they can do to help us energize and dispel negative energy and get rid of things that might be affecting us on a psychological level, emotional level, or psychic level. So first we have Les Bell, and I want to tell our guests today, when did you start your work, and what is your greatest story you have, and the type of healing that you do?
I learned Reiki in 1998 and went immediately home and worked on my cat for 5 hours, and he says, oh, you done?
Worked on your kitty cat, huh?
My kitty cat, uh-huh. Yes. And I had a friend that had horses, and he had a horse that was shod wrong. And so he asked me to send distant treatment to the horse. And I thought, well, okay. And then she got better, so they were able to work her out of her bad feet. And then he asked me to come see the three horses that he had. And mm-hmm. So I went in there, and she greeted me at the door. She knew who I was. She nickered at me. Mm-hmm. And when I was done, the lead male horse bowed to me, and I didn't realize that that was a big deal until they told me, because mm-hmm. I'm not a horse person. But
wow.
It was a fantastic day.
What was the distance between you, the actual distance between you and the healing scent, the distance, different town? Was the horse in a different state?
I want to say probably about 25 miles.
Oh, 25 miles.
But it doesn't, in distance, I could send out to the universe. It doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
So,
that's right.
Yeah.
Wow. And what's your greatest, when you work with clients, how do you help them work with energy? How do you help them? Do you put them under it like a trance, or do you do hands-on? How do you work with them? What's your method of approach?
I prefer to have one hand or two hands on the client, if nothing, if the shoulders are holding their hands. And Reiki puts you in kind of a trance state. And my voice, when I'm working, I modulate it so that they go under as well. And so what I do is I offer them an alternative to the negative that they're feeling.
Okay.
And they walk into that, and they give me the clues, and I use the clues they give me.
Okay, thank you. That's great, Les. Wonderful. Thank you, Reverend Raea. Wonderful healer that you are. I love you. I think you're great. You've done a lot
thank
of
you.
Work for many, many people.
Thank you.
Tell us your story about how you got started and a healing experience.
Sure. All of this started for me when I had a near-death experience in 2005. And since then, it's like a switch got flipped within mm-hmm. me, and it's been on. Ever since then, I've felt called to use my intuition. I haven't really felt like I've had much of a choice. Mm-hmm. It's just been one thing after another, leading me to people that need to learn how to evolve and develop and move more fully into themselves. And so the process for me of doing this work has really stemmed from that.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. So your experience of near-death experience has made a whole change for you.
It's changed my whole life.
And many in the public have had those near-death experiences. Yeah. So thank you for sharing that so much.
Absolutely.
Wonderful. Okay, Ron. Ron.
Yes.
Kalvin Klein Ron.
I assume the question is the same.
Yes, healing.
I've had an overwhelming desire to find out about metaphysics and healing and things since I was actually 15 or 16.
Mm.
There's precious little information available in those days. Mm-hmm. But over the years, I've had many experiences personally, and I've observed many things. And so consequently, I've learned a lot, which I could speak to because I've been there, done that, as it were.
Yes.
And I have to tell you, even though I don't personally do the healing when it occurs, it's a wonderful experience because you see someone go away so much the better for it.
Yes, yes. I've had different experiences from you and a couple of people we know, and excellent, excellent. The energy shifts and changes in the body almost. You can feel the electricity flow and release tension or stress, and it changes you on a cellular level.
It is.
It really
and
is.
Now
is
they
true?
Can measure the energy around each cell in our body scientifically. And I tell people, if you don't believe that energy is real, go to a World Series game or go to a playoff game. When you walk in the stadium, you will feel something.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
The excitement, that's energy.
True, very true, very true. Right. What do you want to discuss? What about the 21st century? What would we all say together here about what do we need to tell the public in maybe one word, two words, sentence or so, 2012. 2012 is coming. What should the public know from us as healers? What would you say, guys?
Let the fear go and step into the future.
Let the fear go and step into the future.
Stop worrying.
Stop worrying.
I agree with all of those statements, and I would add to that, be flexible.
Be flexible.
For whatever comes, and be willing to experience it because it is going to happen.
Yes. And I would say to everyone out there that it's very important to go with the flow in life by 2012 and also think outside of the box. We all have to think in a new direction, a new release old conditioning possibly. If you go with your new thoughts and new ideas, like we're talking here today, to be open to any kind of energy change or shift that actually is going to be helpful to you to process 2012 and get into 2013 quite easily. So this is Arlene Tognetti for our guest panel today, and wonderful to speak with you. Take care, and we'll talk to you soon.